Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and today on Save Point, we got some very special guests in the room.
Michaela Dietz, I do voiceovers, including Amethyst, on Steven Universe. I dressed up for you today, Austin.
And you look great.
Yeah,
you look
great. I got on my best.
Is this like a mullet situation? Because like business on top and then party in the ripped up jeans?
Yeah, oh yeah, okay. Yeah. I like to think of it more like a rat tail.
Oh,
yeah, there's okay. A little more flair than the mullet.
Okay, I got
what
you.
I mean, it's like I'm not afraid to put the bylane on the back.
And you can know? Tuck it too.
Yeah.
In times of need.
Oh yeah.
That's nice. Yeah. Tucked rat tail. Okay, nice. So on our show, everybody's got nicknames.
Ooh.
So it could be something from childhood or something new that you make up on the
Ooh.
Spot. And again, we'll go this way.
Okay. So just go with it like improv?
Yeah.
Consequences.
Consequences. All right.
Ooh.
Bam.
Sounds like it's been used.
That's a name, and you'll learn. It's very hard for other people to say. All right.
Tonks.
Tonks.
Tonks?
Tonks. Why Tonks?
It's so... It'll take more than time we have.
Inside, though. It's
okay.
Inside. Tell
okay.
me.
It's inside.
Because he looks a little bit like a certain Indian version of a certain wrestler.
Okay.
Ooh.
Got you. Perfect. Wrestling names. Nicknames.
Steve Inoki, like the mushroom, because I like... Yakitori mushrooms, like Inoki.
But not like...
Not like Steve Aoki. Like Steve Inoki.
Inoki. So
yes.
So you're Steve Inoki.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Thank
to
you.
The show. Thank you guys for coming on.
Was that weird?
Yeah, it's really weird. But that's what it's all about. And today, we're playing Tetris.
Yes.
Bam. So, first of all...
Mine's not shuffling. The box
doesn't
just
shuffle.
Move.
It's just yeah.
It's just a square.
The box
that
is just
should.
A square.
Oh, I get it. Games. I was weird as a kid. I was so weird as a kid. I watched like infomercials. I didn't like play games.
It's still just a box.
what infomercials for you?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I was all about that Ron Popeil life.
Ron Popeil?
Yeah.
What is that?
Ron Popeil.
Ron Popeil?
You guys, he had hair in a can. He had that,
Ron
the
Popeil?
Popeil.
Popeil.
Yeah, he had the Ron Popeil, the Ronco food dehydrator. He had a pasta maker. He had, like, I think a fishing rod in, like, a pocket fishing rod.
Yeah, this is all true. I remember all
I don't
things.
Remember any of this.
Oh,
where did you grow up?
Upstate New York, Cooperstown,
oh,
New York.
Okay.
It's home of the Baseball Hall of Fame.
I'm losing. Baseball Hall of Fame, so are you into baseball?
I do like baseball.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you like baseball?
I used to when I was a kid. I lived in Inglewood, California, so I was a big Dodgers fan. But then I moved to Atlanta, so I was like, oh, I should like the Braves, maybe. But then Chipper Jones lied to my face.
What?
It's a very long story. But
okay.
As a child, he lied to my face. And so
like
I,
about something important?
Yes.
Like, is he your dad? Like,
no. Yeah, Chipper Jones is my dad. No. Yeah. So, Chipper Jones came to my school, and I think, I want to say, like, he was just recently signed with the Braves or something like that.
Okay.
We had this thing called, like, Outdoors Day, wherever. We'd
Ooh.
Play a bunch of games outside, and they, remember they had, like, the big parachute?
Yes,
you
and you can go
air.
Under it.
Yeah,
awesome.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
the best. You just run under it and then run back out, or get
okay.
caught underneath and people can't find you. So we did stuff like that. It was called Field Day. And so Chipper Jones was like the guest. And we're like, oh my God, this is awesome. He's from the Braves. This is so cool. So he was eating lunch with us. Yeah,
okay.
He was eating lunch with us at our table. And he bounced around and had lunch with a bunch of different kids'
uh-huh.
tables. And so he's like, oh, you know, I want to do something, but I don't know what to do. I want to do like a picture or something, but I can't give everybody one. I was like, oh, why don't you take the picture or have the 8x10, whatever it is, sign it, photocopy it, then everybody gets one. He goes, that's a great idea. Since you made it, I'll give you the original copy. So
oh.
I'm freaking out all day. I'm about to get Chipper Jones' original signed 8x10. I'm in like first, second grade. End of the day comes. Does a big
okay.
speech. Amazing speech. Great speech. And then everybody gets these photocopied 8x10s. And
okay.
he goes, to the great kid that came up with this idea, they get the original copy. So I'm getting up, like dusting myself off, like so excited. And then he calls up some random like fifth grade girl.
What?
Wow.
He punked you?
It was the worst, and I just lost.
I'm really
horrible.
Sorry you had that experience.
It's so since then, I
yeah.
hated the Braves.
That's like a scam.
It's the worst.
Everybody...
I would imagine, like,
yeah.
So it made me so mad that I denounced them throughout my entire childhood until Chipper Jones wasn't on the team anymore. And then they had that series with the Yankees.
Ugh.
Where, like, they were in this World Ugh. Series for, like, 17 years straight. You beat me, though.
I know, but I don't know what happened.
This is what happens when we're talking and playing games.
Wait, I don't like this guy.
Yeah. So anyway, so,
bad
so, so to finish it up,
yeah.
Finally, the Yankees are just destroying the Braves throughout the World Series, just crushing them. And it's like, wear your team colors to school day during the World Series.
Okay.
Everybody's wearing Braves because we're from Georgia.
Right.
I show up wearing Yankees stuff. Only kid in school. Almost got sent home because I almost got
what? Home.
Yeah, it was serious. We take stuff seriously in the A. But yeah, that's why I didn't like the Braves. Now the Braves are fine now. I have a friend who I went to elementary school with who's on the Braves.
Uh-huh.
Tyler
wow.
Flowers, shout out.
Hi, Tyler.
Yes. Okay, so let's talk about you. This
okay.
is I'm on this all the time. They don't want to hear about me. So okay, so
I
got
hyped. I'm enjoying my time though.
You are a voice actress extraordinaire, and you do the voice of Amethyst from
yeah.
my favorite cartoon of all time, Steven Universe.
All time?
Literally all time. I made that decision a few months ago, actually.
Really?
Yeah, I've been trying to get all my what? Top like five things, and Steven Universe is my favorite cartoon.
Okay, ever. Let me ask you something. Was it between like a couple cartoons?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, yes, it was
difficult. Give me your top.
So my favorite anime is Yu Yu Hakusho.
Okay.
And so I count anime as cartoons as well. So
wait, sorry, I gotta come clean. I don't know any cartoons.
Like cartoons or anime?
Anime or cartoons.
You don't know anything about cartoons?
I mean, I'm just starting to learn.
Like, so you don't know DuckTales?
Oh, I know DuckTales. Woo. Yeah. I do know that one.
So like, okay, so give me a gauge. What's your favorite cartoon?
I like Doug.
Doug is great.
I liked that one.
Doug was on the list.
I liked, does Archer count?
Archer counts, yeah. That's a cartoon.
Okay. I don't know. I was weird when I was little. Again,
that's fine.
I watched like Sisters and like Picket Fences and like shows that like little kids did not watch. I like should have been watching.
What?
Because I remember like, I remember like, Are You Afraid of the Dark?
Are You Afraid of the Dark?
Was
show.
Like too scary for me.
Okay, I peed my pants when I watched it.
Yeah, so I remember being like, oh no, dude, I gotta go see Cela Ward and like,
yeah.
On like Sisters and like a young budding George Clooney. I was just a weirdo.
So then, okay.
Okay, but you like Steven, so
yeah.
That's cool.
I want to dive into like your what you watch as a kid, though.
Oh,
that's...
okay, okay. Let's go.
Okay, so what was your favorite show as a kid, then?
I didn't watch a lot of kid shows, again.
Yeah.
I did like Wheel of Fortune.
Okay.
I did like I like Jeopardy a lot. Of kid shows, I like that one. Was the locker one on Nick, and it's like, hey, Alistair.
Television.
Yeah,
okay.
You
yeah.
can't do that on
okay.
television.
Yep.
That was Canadian, though.
Hey, dude.
Was that a Canadian show?
It was.
What?
Dave Coulier was in it.
Oh. Cut it.
Oh.
Cut
yeah,
it
yeah.
out.
So we don't know that's Full House.
Oh, shoot. You know, he used to French kiss Alanis Morissette.
That's really bad. Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Oh, she
like,
was on it?
Like, you
show.
Live, you learn, you cry, you Ooh. Learn, you let lose, you learn.
Voice of an angel.
Oh no, not even.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't, but thank
you're really
you.
Good.
I appreciate
yeah,
it.
I was shockingly good voice.
Did you hire them to come sit back here?
I did.
Like, you have the best voice
your,
ever.
Your texts are in the mail.
So good, Austin.
Yeah.
I would have said it either way.
Yeah.
Do you have to have a good voice?
I'm not doing well in this game of Tetris.
Yeah, I'll say that.
Hey, you know
you
what?
You don't do a lot of singing.
Are you having fun though?
I'm having a great time.
Okay,
you're obliterating
what,
me.
That's what counts.
Fine. We're all over the place.
Yeah.
Earlier I was telling you about the party at Comic-Con
yeah.
where nobody could get in.
Oh my God.
When I was trying to meet you guys.
Dude, so so Dee Dee, the voice of Pearl, reminded me of that story and I was like, that was him?
Yeah.
I totally forgot. And
that
I
was
remember
me being a total creep trying to meet you guys.
But like people were so upset. Like the writers are such huge wrestling fans.
Yeah.
And like I remember there was a lot of hubbub.
Oh, there was?
In the pizza restaurant, being
I'll
like, I can't believe they wouldn't let him in.
I'll take that.
Yeah.
I like hubbub.
Yeah.
So, okay.
Yeah.
So, anyway, I meet Samantha Newark.
Okay.
I'm cheesing out. My friend is like, oh, come to this party. A bunch of people that work with Steven Universe are there. I'm like, oh my God, can I get in? Yeah, come by. So, come by, try to get in, can't get in. So, I'm like, okay, that's fine. You know, it's a thing. People come outside, they work with the show. I'm talking
yeah.
to them. They're like, oh, I think she wants to meet you too. And I turn around and Rebecca Sugar is like right here.
So, you're
and
like,
I kind of lost it a little
like,
bit.
Like, what do you mean? Like, describe in which
like,
way you lost
losing
it.
Losing it, like, I wasn't like.
Did you
like,
lose yourself
I
in
wasn't,
the moment?
I did, like Eminem style.
That's so
I wasn't like tears down my face, streaming, weeping. But there were tears. There were tears in my eyes about to come out, and I
like man, like a manly weep.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
cool.
Yeah. Like a little sniffle.
But
okay.
like when Flair walked by, so just like. Oh.
It's different things for different people, you know.
Yeah.
And I
yeah.
never. I hadn't understood, I hadn't felt that before, like ever. Like that to me, so like my idols in life are Jackie Chan and Lenny Kravitz.
Okay.
And so like, I didn't realize like that's what happens when you meet somebody that has like altered your existence like that. Because the work that you guys do on this show in like 8 million different realms like touches your soul.
Dude.
Like it's not a cartoon. It's like...
It's definitely more than a cartoon.
It's a life-changing experience.
The cool part about it is, I mean, obviously you're passionate about it. There are so many people who like also feel it, who are, you know, totally different from you, totally different from me.
Yeah.
It's crazy how the show can seem so personalized and yet it's like so broad reaching.
Yeah.
To so many different types of people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm very curious as to what children feel when they watch the show. Like, because I understand, like, so back in the day with cartoons, so like we're talking about DuckTales and stuff, there's messages underneath, yes, the woo-woo. There's messages underneath the episodes and what's going on. I feel like a lot of cartoons don't have that now, but Steven does it better than any cartoon I've ever seen before. So like watching it as an adult, whenever Steven learns something about his mom, but he doesn't fully understand like the gravity of the situation. He's just learning more stuff about this mom he never met. And like as an adult, you're processing all this like, oh my God, this is so important to how he's gonna live his life from here on out, like become an adult. Like, and so one time watching an episode, it was the one where Steven first went into Lion and got the VHS tape.
Straight to video?
My God.
Lion straight to video?
My God.
Dude, I was weeping.
Why are you reading?
I was like uncontrollably, but like with force, being like, that stuff's moving.
It's too much.
It's too much. Like the way that Rebecca Sugar can just like play with your emotions in 11 minutes.
Yeah.
It's insane.
It's not fair.
It's insane.
It's not fair.
Yeah.
So we had
I just screamed about that.
As you should.
Really
as you should. It's passion. It's, and your face is twitching. You're just like, ah.
Yeah.
Wish I was as passionate about anything.
So we're on like an international flight and I'm watching that episode. I got headphones on.
Okay.
And by the end of it, after, when like the tape ends and Steven says whatever he says, like I'm at this point, I am crying. I am openly weeping.
Yeah.
So like I'm losing my mind. And this woman next to me, she taps me. She's like, sir, are you okay? Cause I'm like, it's not quiet. And I'm like, and I go to answer, but then her daughter next to her, who I believe was a teenager, she goes, she sees my phone.
Oh,
she's like,
she knows.
He's watching Steven Universe, mom, just let him cry. And I was like, yes, I'm dead serious. Like, they get it.
She knows.
Yeah, people know.
She knows.
When you watch Steven, the feels are real.
Yeah.
Like, it'll turn
a
cold-hearted person.
It's a field trip.
Yeah.
Have you seen that meme? And it's like getting ready for this week's Steven bomb.
Yeah.
And it's Pearl in like three different fetal positions. Just being like, no. Nah! Because she's just going crazy.
It's so good. When you started with this show, did you know, like, could you feel what it was going to be when you were reading for it?
Or
was
it just like, okay, I knew it was special from the pilot when I first auditioned for it.
Yeah.
I mean, the dialogue's so awesome.
Yeah.
It was so poignant, like, from the get-go. Mm-hmm. But then I had no idea it would affect so many people on this level. Like, when I go to conventions, like at MomoCon, I met a couple different kids who were like, yo... Like, thank you so much. Amethyst has helped me come out to my parents.
Mm-hmm.
Or like, I hated myself. I hated my body type. Like, people told me that I like didn't deserve to live because I was fat. And now, like, you've inspired me. Which I'm like, it's not me. It's like a character. And like, you know what I mean? It's like Rebecca Sugar. It's the crooner. It's like not Michaela Dietz. But you know, it's affected so many different people.
Yeah.
And the show has a huge online following.
Mm-hmm.
And it really, they're a very vocal bunch.
Yeah.
So I get to hear from them a lot online. And it's really special. I've never been a part of a project like that before.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, when I was on Barney and Friends, there weren't like 2-year-olds
Wait.
Oh, you didn't know that? I thought you knew that.
No. Barney and Friends.
Oh yeah, it was Cousin Riff. So they tried to resurrect the show with a new cousin who's like, head would light up. And like, he would like, I was like, oh, I'll be edgy. And I like, for my audition, I like rapped Happy Birthday.
Like, can you do that?
I had no business rapping. I was like, Happy Birthday to you. It was so lame. Like, I feel sorry for myself. You know what I mean? And they're like, oh, she's edgy. And then I like moved to Texas for a little bit and like did that. But that show was cool. But, you know, you're not, like, hearing from 2-year-olds about the the impact on their lives.
Man, when I was two and I watched that show, you guys were killing it.
Yeah, but now I meet kids at these conventions who are like, I loved Riff, and I always apologize. I'm like, I'm sorry, you'll never get that time back.
Yeah. Gone forever.
Yeah.
Do you find that people from all ages are coming up to you saying this? Yeah.
Not sound creeps, but I will get, like, I often get a lot of dads.
Yeah.
Like, who are like, oh, my son loves this show. So, Michaela, who's your favorite character? What do you, you know what I mean? Clearly, it's like this 3-year-old who's like, oh, the colors are pretty. And then this dad being like, Michaela, I need the inside track. And like, it's like, Trevor, ask questions. Trevor's like, I don't know what the hell's going on. I'm like,
Oh, you're the purple one.
Yeah. The show has a very impressive reach.
Yeah.
And it's cool. I think it's really cool that it can reach little kids and their parents and their grandparents, like, all in one swoop.
Yeah,
you know?
It's wild. So, unfortunately, we have to stop.
We really did it.
Killing it. Great high five.
Thanks.
You know the secret, right?
Yeah.
Look at the elbow.
The elbow.
Dang. I didn't even have to. I just sensed it.
You just have it.
Yeah.
There's the bond.
I love
it. Well, thank you guys for being on.
Yeah.
This is the thing. I always forget nicknames.
Oh, it's okay.
They get so intense.
Steven,
you're a consequence.
I'm consequence.
Consequence. Yes. Like the rapper.
Yeah.
Like the rapper consequence.
You're right.
It's
on the tip of your tongue.
Tonks. Tonks. Steve Aoki.
Like the mushroom.
Bam, mushroom.
With delicious
texture. Okay. It's fungus.
But it's delicious. You don't like the texture of a gnocchi mushroom?
I don't like the texture of mushrooms or vegetables.
Mushrooms are pretty good.
Whoa, or vegetables, just blankets, blanket vegetables.
Vegetables minus broccoli and cauliflower.
Oh, okay.
How'd you make your muscles?
Hard work and determination, bro.
meat.
I'm like, can I get some of that?
Yeah,
oh,
just eat meat. Red meat.
I've been lying to my kids.
Bad for your heart, great for your biceps. So, we gotta wrap this one up. Make sure you follow your boy Austin Creed on Twitter at Xavier Woods PhD. Follow
at Whammy Ba.
Yeah,
on Twitter,
how do we spell
YouTube,
it?
Instagram. WHAMMYBAH, like Whammy Bar, but it's a Whammy Ba.
Whammy!
Whammy Ba!
Bam! Okay, thank you guys for being on.
Thank you. Do you want this?
Ah!
For being you and being special.
I get a Stephen pin, which is great because. On my backpack.
Man. It's a native gold. They make the coolest stuff. What?
Oh, man.
I am covered in pins.
I felt the burn.
Yeah.
Majorly.
I thought it was going to be a box of booties.
Yeah.
No.
There is.
Oh, well, there is a box of booties.
Yeah.
That's
awesome. I have these pins on my back, so it's going to go in my bag with all my other glorious pins.
Yes.
So, again, thank you guys for being on so much. It's been very fun. You guys like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. Make sure you go and follow them on all their social media accounts. But always and forever, make sure you keep it tight. It's a catchphrase. It's a weird thing.
Tight.
Bye.